Today's stars, tomorrow's leaders. Slovakia will host the 2015 Winter Universiade alongside Granada, Spain. We'll start with the latest news from the Nordic ski venue in Strubske Pleso. We also focus on Ostroblie, the biathlon venue, and we'll show you how the universities and athletes in Slovakia are preparing for the 27th Winter Universiade. And in part three of Campus Sport magazine, we meet our guest Adam Zampa and report on the World University Boxing Championships in Yakutsk, Russia.
Hello, I'm Danka Bartekova and I'm an ambassador of the 27th Winter Universiade here in Slovakia. We're going to host the competitions in Štrbské Pleso and Ostroblie, and let's have a look how enthusiastic we are in preparations.
The 27th Winter Universiade is only the fourth worldwide sports event organized by Slovakia. For former sports shooter Danka Bartekova, the combination of the Universiade and Slovakia is definitely the right one.
By hosting the Universiade, Slovakia will again be on a sport map. So to host an event like this, it's a great honor for us. It's a great event for Slovakia.
The High Tatra Resort Strubska Pleso will stage the Nordic ski events at the Universiade. The reason for this is that the 2015 host venue, Granada in Spain, doesn't have a suitable venue to stage some of the events. So Slovakia stepped in to help just 8 months ago.
We take this quite late, so it's quite difficult to improve some more legacy for those games. But we're trying to involve as much volunteers and university to prepare this Universiade. We had already Universiade twice, and now it was a long time ago. Now we want to show that we can do it again, and we can show actually people here in Slovakia that we can do nice event for young athletes. So.
The Slovakian organisers are experienced. Two Universiades have already been staged in the Tatras, in 1987 and 1999 in Poprad. The last World Cup event took place in Strubske Pleso in 2001. The existing venues have been refurbished.
We have offered the FISU people the special plan to improve the condition in our sport venue here in Štrbské Pleso. It means here in the jumping area, we have decided to realize the installation of the cooling system of the in run of the jumping hill, and in the cross-country stadium, we have decided to prepare a new part of the 2.5 and 5 kilometer cross-country lap behind the blind lake here in this area.
In order to avoid a lack of snow, the organizers have installed a cooling system to meet the parameters of artificial snow. And everything has been achieved in less than 8 months, a difficult challenge for the tourist resort.
It was a very hard work for us because you must imagine that Štrbské Pleso is also the summer area for the tourism here in our region. And that's why during the summer period here was more than 1 million of visitors, and that's why especially the external work wasn't possible to realize outside during this main season, and so that's why we have started practically from the beginning of the September only.
As Strubska Pleso is part of the Tatra National Park, the organizers had to adapt the modifications to the existing facilities to stay within strict levels of environmental protection. They propose a sustainable venue finished on schedule.
We hope the construction works here in Štrbské Pleso is going to be finished before the first snow is coming beginning of December.
330 athletes from 31 countries will come to the region. The organizing committee has already resolved their accommodation requirements and are now finalizing the challenge of the transport system, an important part of the athletes' well-being at the Universiade.
are really looking forward to welcoming the athletes from all over the world. And I think the biggest benefit for the visitors will be the welcome and the hospitality of Slovak people.
From the 24th of January to the 1st of February, Strupska Pleso wants to create the best conditions for the athletes in ski jumping, cross country and Nordic combined in order for them to enjoy the games. Skeet shooter Danka Bartikova, a multiple world and European championship medalist, has become the ambassador and the face of the Universiade. But who is Danka Bartikova, the elite athlete who became a sports leader both inside and outside Slovakia?
In the shooting range, I can be whoever I want to, because then it's about achieving, it's about working hard and getting what I want. So this is something very special for me. But outside the shooting range, I want to use my potential to help the people, to represent the athletes, to do what I want and what I can to make sport in Slovakia much better.
As a member of the IOC Commission of Athletes, Danka knows what athletes really need during a big competition.
What I'm really personally looking forward to is meeting the athletes, talking to them, finding out what's bothering them, what they need, what they want. And it's going to be a very good personal input for me, because then I can forward their needs a little bit further.
In 2010, Danka was crowned European Skeet Champion for the second time. A year later, she participated in her second Summer Universiade in Shenzhen, arriving in China as one of the favorites for an amazing competition.
The competition in Shenzhen was amazing for me, because we were there with my teammate. We were shooting really, really well. We were one of the favorites, so everyone counted on us getting the medals. But we never expected to shoot off for a gold medal against each other, so it was quite an experience for me. I took the silver. This was one of the shoot-offs I lost, but still the experience stays in my heart forever. Regarding the value of the medal in my collection, I think it's quite high, because it's just a single one. It's from a multi-sport event. It was a very tough competition, and it prepared me for the following competitions.
2012 was by far the best year of her career so far. She won the World Cup final in Maribor, and after taking eighth place at the 2008 Beijing Olympics, she came to the London Games with high ambitions.
I told myself, okay, this is going to be a good day, and it was. And just getting the medal, knowing that my parents watching from home, they were not in London, and a lot of people watching from Slovakia, and knowing that maybe they are a little bit proud of me, it was great. It was a relief, it was a dream come true, and it was achieving one of the biggest goals in my life.
Another goal in her life is to finish her studies in international relations at the Banka Bystrica University of Political Sciences in Slovakia. Danka has always tried to combine her sport and academic studies to a high level.
Personally, I really wanted to study since being a kid, because I knew that the school and what I learned during my life is what I will use later. So I always wanted to finish the school, which I did, and still I'm a student still, because I'm still on a PhD studies in my university.
The 2012 World University Champion was introduced to shooting by her father, who was a hunter. And since becoming an athlete, she's been hunting results, medals, and ever-improving performances.
Working hard on ourselves, on myself, because it's still developing. I'm still not a good athlete. I'm still reaching higher, bringing some news in my preparation, trying to be better and better. And this is what really fascinates me, just reaching our limits, getting better, and achieving more.
This year, Danka was back on the podium with a World Cup victory in Tucson, USA. But even while competing at the highest level, she won't forget about promoting the Winter Universiade in her home country.
I'm happy that the sport will be closer to the people, so everyone here in the northern part of Slovakia, but not only from here. From the whole Slovakia, we'll have a chance to see the high-level sport even very close, and this is the greatest benefit that we can have.
Danka, a role model, and not only for Slovakia. In part two, we go to Ostroblie, Slovakia's biathlon venue, and a venue for the Winter Universiade biathlon events. We'll also see how the region's university supports athletes like Jana Gantnerova.
When education meets sport and culture, what best promotes excellence in mind and body? Where do friendship, integrity, and achievement meet? Which event gathers the best student-athletes from around the world? The Universiade, the home of international university sports. Today's stars, tomorrow's leaders.
Ostroblie is situated in the Banská Bystrica region of central Slovakia and will host the biathlon competitions at the 2015 Winter Universiade. 391 inhabitants live in this small village and they are hoping to benefit from the event, just like the young talents of the region. I think it is really good to have the Universiade here because we can meet and watch our biathlon idols. And for sure, the venue will be better after the competitions also. And hopefully, we can practice at this venue and practice alongside our idols. We can learn from these athletes, so if we're doing something wrong, we can change it and practice in a better way. Ostroblie already has existing facilities, built to host past international competitions like the 2010 European Championships, experience that will be helpful in organising the Universiade.
I
have to say that Ostroblie is the centre of Slovak biathlon. In the past already, World Championships were organised here in 1997. And now, every year, we organize the IBU Cup. It's a second category event of the championship. Concerning Universiade, it's an important event for us because we can promote ourselves to a wider public. And it will also help us to finish the construction of our multifunctional building. And then, of course, it will be a great promotion for Slovak biathlon, not just for young people, but also for the public. Like Strubska Pleso, the venue has been refurbished by building one multifunctional complex, an important investment not only for the local youth, but also for Slovakian biathlon. This building has its own story. The construction work started in 2008, but because of a lack of money, the works were stopped 1 year later in 2009. So then we could restart again with the construction in 2013. It means a long-term process, and this building is necessary for the venue if we want to apply for a World Cup event. The building will be finished by the end of November and will have a real impact on young biathlon talents like Beata Zelenčíková. Beata's life as an athlete will certainly change in future. We will be able to train better and more because of the improvements here. And that can allow us, perhaps, to participate at a Universiade in the future. This Universiade will be helpful for us. In the meantime, Beata will certainly watch the biathlon events at the Winter Universiade next January in Ostroblie, cheering on the local hero, Natalia Prekopova, winner of the 15K gold at the last games in Trentino 2013. Comenius University in the Slovakian capital Bratislava was founded in 1919. It's the largest university in the country with more than 30,000 students. FISU member and vice president of the Universiade organizing committee Dusan Hamar believes the event will have a real impact on the youth of Slovakia.
Even the younger students and the younger kids, they can see that it's possible to combine, you know, sport, even on the elite, on the top level, with the studies. And I think that's the message of university. In FISU, we really like to combine, you know, the spirit, the study, you know, the knowledge, education and sport.
A professor in sports medicine, Mr. Hamar knows that the Winter Universiade will offer much to Slovakian students, just like the 1999 Winter Universiade did in Poprad. He's expecting the same level of enthusiasm.
A great chance for them, you know, to meet people, to make contacts. And I remember last time, and they were crying when the games were over. So that's one very important aspect that young people can, you know, can meet the, you know, the foreign athletes, foreign competitors, and exchange ideas and culture.
For him, the upcoming Winter Universiade also has a mission to stage an event that will leave a lasting legacy for Slovakian society in general. At the Economics University in Bratislava, Mr. Julius Dubovsky, president of the National University Sports Association, already has organizational experience from previous Universiades, and he's a busy man, working around the clock to guarantee a high quality of competition. The impact of this event in Slovakia is and will be important and positive because of the engagement and participation of Slovak students. When we asked for volunteers, the response was great. More than 1,000 Slovak and 400 foreign students applied. I think it's a very important aspect. From 25,000 Slovakian students, over 250 top-level athletes are currently at university and competing in Olympic Games, World and European Championships and Universiades, and all are helped by the National Sports Association. Students or athletes who are participating in this kind of event are supported by scholarships or grants. It's not a big amount, but I think it's enough. So they can prepare in their clubs, but they're also supported by their sports associations. Slovakian alpine skiing star Adam Zampa and Trentino alpine skiing winner Jana Gantnerova are supported by the National University Sports Association heading into the 2015 Winter Universiade. Jana Gantnerova is Slovakia's biggest hope for the alpine skiing events at the Universiade in Granada, Spain, having already won 3 medals at the Games in Trentino and Erzurum. The former student has always managed to combine sports and academic studies during her career.
It wasn't that long. I finished my school. It was only in May this year. I always love to come back here and feel these rememberings of my 5 years of life in this university. I did study 3 years international business, and then another 2 years of master in tourism management. And I did study this because it's either easiest thing, so it can be really good synchronized with skiing and also my athlete life. Well, first of all, it was about discipline, because after the year of skiing, you had to come back to school and learn. It was really hard to do, but I wanted to achieve my degrees, so I did it.
She started ski racing at the tender age of 4. Her mother was a well-known ski racer in Slovakia. In the beginning, it wasn't really her choice, but she grew to love the sport.
I have a really good feeling of skis. I was born with it. I get to feel it because I was skiing so long. But I think, well, after a lot of injuries, I have to improve my physics in this moment because I didn't stand up on skis really much this year. So I have still almost 4 months to improve this.
She injured her knee during the Sochi Olympics, which required surgery in March. Her motivation to return to competition are the memories of her excellent Winter Universiade performances, like Erzurum 2011.
I was actually ill. So 1 week before my medal, I was lying in the bed with the flu, and then I was really tired for the races, and I really could have reached the gold medal, but I was happy with the bronze medal at the moment. So it was just pure happiness. And I was happy that my mother would be proud, because she's always when I make some result.
2 years later, Jana trained hard for the Trentino Universiade in Italy, and her efforts were rewarded. In good shape, the young skier took more medals.
I was really surprised because I reached the silver medal in downhill, what's not really my special discipline. And that was in the beginning of university, and it was really good and then calming, because I have this free head for the next races, and I also get to reach gold medal in the combination.
Although Jana has graduated, she is allowed to compete in one more Universiade in Granada. She doesn't know at this stage if she'll continue to compete at elite level, but she's still ambitious.
I have a big goal. I want at least one medal, so we'll see about it. I will be for sure ready for the Winter Universiade 2015 in Granada.
Jana Gantnerova doesn't know if she can win another medal for her collection, but she knows one thing. She'll definitely enjoy her third Winter Universiade. In the last part of Campus Sport magazine, we'll focus on the skiing star Adam Zampa competing at the Granada Winter Universiade. And we'll move to Yakutsk in Russia, where the 6th World University Boxing Championships took place. He's the big favourite for the alpine skiing competitions in Granada. Adam Zampa surprised everyone last season with very good performances on the World Cup, and especially in Sochi, where he finished 5th in the combined and 6th in the slalom. Even though he's competing in Spain, he's happy that his country will co-host the Universiade.
The biggest advertisement in the world is to have some good sport event like World Cup, Universiade, or Winter Olympic Games or Olympic Games. And I know we had Universiade before, I think in 1999. And I don't remember it so good because I was young, I was only 9 years old. It's a really big event for Slovakia.
Adam comes from a skiing family, 4 generations of skiers. He got the alpine bug and started to train and compete at the age of 12, guided, of course, by a family member.
My trainer, my father, always did everything for my good technique and to make it very clean and to be patient on the outside skis. And maybe that's why I am strong in slalom, because slalom is very technical discipline. And I think my technique is not so bad.
Adam prepared for last season with summer training in New Zealand, where he performed well, arriving for the Trentino Universiade in confident mood.
I remember I started with a giant slalom. It was not so good for me because I want to catch a medal also in giant slalom. But after first run, I made a mistake and it was very hard. And then in the second run, I was attacking, but I finished 9th, I think. And in slalom, everybody wants that I will get a medal. But yeah, it was kind of pressure for me, but I also want to catch a medal. And after first run, I know it was very bumpy conditions there. And I had number 15, I think. I was not so good number. Because of the bib draw. And my first run was really good. I was leading after the first run, but in second run I made a little mistake and I finished second. So it was also good to finish second, but I was a little bit angry, it's not called.
Don't take me time. The 23-year-old skier knows that an athlete's career is not a long one. He's preparing for his future and studying economics at the Banka Bystrica University. Later on, he wants to work in the hotel business. But for now, being an elite athlete at university is tough.
For all professional athletes, it's very hard to study during the professional sport because you are always away, you always do trainings, and sometimes it's very hard to compare it with studying.
Adam is an ambitious athlete, working hard to achieve his goals, to win medals at the World Championships in Beaver Creek and at the Winter Universiade in Granada.
I for sure want to be for the first, because everybody is always asking only for the winners. There is its possibility to also make a good FISU points for the world ranking, and also it's kind of prestige to be the world champion of all university students, because it cannot say everybody, and it's also kind of a good award.
Adam Zampa is well on the way for outstanding performances and medals at the Winter Universiade in Spain. The 6th World University Boxing Championships took place in Yakutsk, Russia. More than 80 athletes representing 12 countries across the different weight categories participated in the event. The championship was organized in the sports training center, Triumph. FISU has strong contacts with the Russian Boxing Federation. Last year was the Universiade in Kazan, where boxing was included for the first time. And we had no problems at all with the organization for this event. For the first time, 6 out of 78 participants are women. In the 51-kilo category, Russian Sayana Sagatieva and Korean Bak Chorong took gold. In the 60 kilos, it was gold for another Russian, Anastasia Balyakova. The championship is often the start of an international career for many athletes.
This championship was for me an important stage, because Olympic Games comes, and it's important to make medals in this kind of tournament.
At the end of the championships, the Russian boxers took 7 gold medals, 2 silver and 2 bronze, the hosts leading the medal table and taking first place in the team event. Among them, 2 local Yakut athletes, Vasily Egorov and Daman Kutubekov. The 6th World University Boxing Championships in the land of Olonko was a great success, and next time it'll be held in 2016 in Thailand. We'll finish this campus sport magazine looking forward to Granada 2015. Spain will stage the ice and alpine skiing events from the 4th to the 14th of February, and is preparing for the second biggest sports event in the world. And we'll bring you the latest news about those preparations for the Granada Winter Universiade in our next campus sport magazine. We'll see you then.
Today's stars, tomorrow's leaders,